Check. 1, 2, 1, 2, 1, 2, 1, 2. Got my Nashville, Tennessee hat because I'm moving. Big announcement. Big things. Episode number 9.
Number nine.
With a new guest.
9 weeks straight.
Eli, where you at, bro?
Is nine?
Are we on? Tell us where we're on.
We're rolling.
Good.
That was it.
Episode number nine.
I feel like nine's got some crazy
episode number. Shout out meaning. To the consistency.
Woo. Every week.
First and foremost, let's get these ginger shots. Look like we have some pre-made ginger shots today.
This one says, look at the meter on the back. It says spicy.
That's spicy.
Oh, damn.
You know what number nine means in the universe?
Tell us. Not saying
that, you know, I represent this, but I think in a way I also do represent this.
Okay.
It means fulfillment.
Fulfillment.
Completion. Not saying it's
an end.
I got a
big announcement to make to tell you
guys
how
this one smells pretty good, actually, from the smell.
It would be a good idea if we've got our special guest. He's going to try one with us as well. We've got a legendary guest today, guys. Stay tuned. All right, cheers, y'all.
Cheers.
To
health.
Fulfillment, health.
And ginger. That was too tasty.
It's got a little bit.
That one's really tasty.
A little bite.
That's good.
It's good though,
I like
right?
this one. Shout out to Tulua. You guys should sponsor us. I would drink these again.
I stood at this row for like 5 minutes.
If Mother's sponsored us, I'd be a little bummed. I'll be honest.
Yo, Mother's is crazy.
That one's gnarly.
That one
but
makes
it's probably because it's the best one.
That was probably really good for you.
So what's new?
All right.
What's new? What's
we got
exciting?
Some stuff.
The first thing.
Yeah.
That's new, in case y'all didn't know. I'm moving to Nashville.
Gonna miss you.
Yeah, I'm moving to Nashville. Yeah. It's that
happy
dope.
For you, though.
Thank you.
I'm happy for you. I might visit for sure.
I've never driven somewhere where the front yards are the size of football fields.
Jeez.
A place like called that. Bellmead.
Bellmead?
Yeah, I'm moving there. Nice knowing you guys.
What's
you guys
the price
gonna be
there?
Okay?
What's
the
price point there?
You know, that was kind of the interesting thing. Like, you'd think, oh, okay, people are moving to Nashville because you get a deal. These homes were probably all 10 million up.
That's crazy. So it's rich.
It's beautiful. Like I went to a really good friend of mine's home. Shout out to my dude, Justin Prepero. He moved out there. Mm-hmm. And his home is in a beautiful neighborhood. It's on over an acre. Gorgeous. Like,
wow.
I get it. While we're hanging out in Justin's patio... Like enclosed patio, you know, you just see two baby deer out in his backyard.
Oh.
Yeah, it was amazing.
Just immersed
like,
in
I get
nature.
It.
That's cool.
I'm pretty sure I was like one of the first 10 Filipino dudes to ever go to the state. So I feel like I was like a pioneer. Like it was very new, you know. But I'm not moving to Nashville. But I want to shout out all of our clients who have moved out there, and all the agents who reached out. I only got a chance to connect with a few of you, but I could see Case in Nashville.
That'd be cool.
For real.
I'll go there for sure.
We should all roll out.
We should.
Yeah.
I need to experience Nashville and Montana still. I haven't experienced Montana.
Oh, man,
yet.
You'd love Montana.
I just want to go there and do some, like, guy stuff, some man stuff. Eat a steak.
What kind of guy stuff
would
you do?
Eat a steak and drive a truck. Yeah. Have a shovel somewhere. I don't know.
Fishing.
Go fishing.
Yeah.
Wear the big boots and the nice stuff.
Yeah.
Just,
gut a fish.
I don't need blood on me. It's just like.
That's pretty much what you have to do. Like, eating a steak and driving
some
a
animals,
truck doesn't
yeah.
really qualify you as a man. You need to gut a fish.
And here it does.
All right, man.
And here it does.
Well, we're here.
We're here.
We've had some cool stuff happen. On the real estate side, man, we had some great deals. We finally put one of our favorite homes into escrow. This is a home that, you know, usually at like the 60 to 90 day mark of us having listings, it's kind of like, ugh. But this was one that was honestly easy to keep the inspiration up because of the story, the message behind it, the architecture. But it was a challenge in the way the bedrooms were set up. And so you never know what's going to be the cause of a listing being challenging to sell. Mm-hmm. But long story short, we had the opportunity to bring forth a buyer, put the buyer into escrow. They're ecstatic. We're in the middle of inspections right now, and that's going well.
That's awesome.
And then Steven and I put a home into escrow in the Heights. Kind of interesting. I went on a listing appointment on this home 2 years ago with young Johnye West.
Oh.
Yeah, Johnye set an appointment there. We did not get the listing. Shout out to Johnye, by the way.
Yeah, for real.
Following, he left real estate to follow his pursuit of creating legendary surf content. Mm-hmm. And I think he's killing it.
It's crushing.
Right?
I heard he's doing well.
I heard he's doing well. Mm-hmm. Some dude wanted to fight him on social, which means he must be doing well.
That's good.
He pissed somebody off.
That's good.
Anyways, we're in escrow on that property now. I didn't get the listing 2 years ago, but we did get our buyer's offer accepted. Mm-hmm. So that's exciting. The home's
Second
incredible.
House.
Can't wait to share it. We got big news this week. This Saturday.
We got
a fun Saturday. I don't know which thing to talk about first.
Let's just go in order.
Let's go in order.
So let's talk about how you can start off your morning Woo! This Saturday Woo! In the most incredible way possible.
Let's go.
Look, we've had two already, and I hope you're able to make it to the first two. If you haven't, this is a new opportunity to come out.
Yeah.
Again, mm-hmm. 7 a.m., 1804 Newport Boulevard. Meeting in the back parking lot, Case Run Club, number
three.
Come
through.
It's number three.
Number three.
As someone who doesn't run... If I wasn't at Case, I would still enjoy coming to this run club.
Yeah. Dude.
And I'm not a runner.
Exactly.
And I enjoy coming here because the environment. I came last weekend and I didn't even run. I just hung out with everyone.
I'm going to keep it real. If you don't feel like running and you just want to cheer the runners mm-hmm. on
yeah.
and be around the vibe, we're actually totally okay with that.
I mean, we had people bring bikes.
Yeah.
You can bring a skateboard or a scooter. Honestly, what's funny is like this run club is not even about running.
No,
it's just
totally
like,
not.
That's just an activity that we do and
yes.
we bond over.
Yes.
But it's more about connecting with awesome
yeah.
people, having a lot of fun, spreading positivity. And it's honestly such an incredible way to start your Saturday morning. It's impossible to leave without at least, I think, meeting three new people.
100%.
Mm-hmm. And it's impossible to leave without a smile on your face.
Yeah. Dude, that's
it's
awesome.
It's fun. It's a good time. We're going to have food there this time.
Yeah.
It's going to be the most epic one yet. So I would love to see everyone there.
Heck yeah.
And like always, everyone's invited, whether you're a new runner, whether you're a first-time runner, whether you're an experienced runner, come out.
Cyclist.
Yeah, whatever. Rollerblade, cyclist, skateboarder.
What kind of food we got?
We got some food.
We got food.
Really?
We got food. Breakfast tacos.
Oh, what?
We'll have some recovery snacks provided by us.
Yo, let's go.
You know, so it's going to be a really good time. This is going to be the most epic one yet.
Oh, I can't wait, man. I can't wait.
It's going to be fun.
Yeah, again, if you're interested in just being a part of like the applause committee and... We have finally figured out the path. We have
yeah.
changed the path a couple times, but the last one was almost perfect.
Yep.
So it was 98% perfect. We have perfected the path this time. And so we're going to do something a little special this time. Where I'm not going to say what it is now,
yeah.
but you'll see when you get to the run club, we're changing it up. Because remember what we were talking about? With like
yes. It's gonna be fun. Just show up. Like
if you just show up,
I guarantee
it's gonna be tight.
You're not gonna be disappointed.
Yeah. Now
that's in the morning.
Later that day.
Some stuff is going down.
What started off as a little bit of a debate over mm-hmm. which was the better place to live between two of our extraordinary agents, who just kinda happened to be in a similar weight class. And Kyle had his opinions of the beautiful Orange County coast,
yeah.
the schools, the lifestyle,
the air here, is
the lack
different.
Of traffic,
the
ability to just go to the beach anytime,
mm-hmm.
the safety,
the people,
and young Keven Vigil had his thoughts to say about
yeah.
Los Angeles,
yeah, yeah,
and the beaches there, the culture. The architecture,
mm-hmm.
you know, it was like the beef started all about architecture and how there isn't any dope homes in Orange County. And you just went in, it got heated, and it was like, guys, why don't you guys just take care of this mano y mano?
Like a man.
You guys aren't going to ever resolve this. Why don't you get in the ring?
So a ring we're getting in.
A ring we're getting in.
The best you can say right here.
I gotta be conscious of what I say on this podcast.
Say whatever you feel.
I don't know, bro.
I don't think Kev's ready for what's gonna come, to be honest.
Man.
I don't think he knows.
Yeah.
Like, I think I think he's brave and he has the guts to commit to this, but I don't think he fully thought it through. Mm. To be honest, I really don't.
Do you have any?
I get it. I don't think, because no one's seen me box. No one thinks I'm a boxer. They just think I'm
right.
An agent, business person, blah blah blah.
Arms are kind of small.
Yeah, whatever. But anyways, I don't think he really thought I was gonna take this serious.
What has this done for you? Like your energy, your mm-hmm. mindset. You know what I mean.
Physically, I'm on a different level than I was a year ago.
Really?
And I think
we were all kind of concerned for you with the amount of Sour Patch candy intake, fact that you don't know what broccoli is.
I had broccoli.
The fact that you've never eaten lettuce before.
No, I had squash last night. Squash,
right? Well,
that's
now,
crazy.
Eggplant.
Yes.
Yeah. Who would have thought last week you would come and run 7 miles with me?
I think for real, I think
that was pretty crazy.
Yeah, so crazy. I bet Kyle $1,000.
I remember this.
Possibly $10,000. I don't remember how much.
Well, that was set up anyway. I was coming
this
off
was
of a bad night
2 years ago.
I remember.
And I bet him something. Like, I think it was a G if he could beat me in a 5K.
I was coming off
dad.
A long
I'm
night.
An old crusty dad. Like, I'm 41, you know what I mean, with so many kids, just overworked.
I'm down to
underslept,
run it back. We can run it back.
You know what I mean? Unappreciated. And I got out there with my old crusty dad shoes a couple years ago and just smoked you. Just put you to shame. I thought you were going to die.
So
out
the
there.
Thing is, though, I've never been a runner. And
look
that was the first
now.
Time I tried, like, long-distance running. Even though it was a 5K.
But I will say, Kev...
Crazy.
I saw my boy Kyle in the ring, and I'm concerned. Yeah. I think it's going to be a short fight.
I think so, too. Sheesh. I think it'll be fun. I think he probably will have some skill sets that, you know, will be fun to test. But there's going to be some holes in his game that I think.
Oh, he might give you some surprises. That
I think
reach,
so.
I bet you he's got a nice uppercut.
I think he's a southpaw, and southpaws can be
you
tricky.
With the terminology.
And I've sparred a couple southpaws,
got
and southpaws.
Some spies into
yeah,
this camp.
They're pretty tricky. It's
this guy watched Creed once, and now he
knows
everything.
Yeah, we did it once. But nah, southpaws are tricky to fight. But we have a game plan coming into this fight, and I think.
All right. So how can people? How can?
Okay, so tickets are gonna go on sale officially, like within the next 24 hours.
Yeah.
You'll see the link. It's limited space. You can also just show up and buy a ticket there, but you're going to need a wristband to get in. And it's like a whole event.
Yeah, it's a whole event.
The Canelo fight, everything.
The Canelo fight is afterwards. It's going to be like a mini car show, food. The KASE Bounce House is going to make its first appearance, so it's for kids as well.
Yeah, it's going to be
fun. It's going to be a good time.
Yeah.
Come run in the morning.
Yeah.
Do whatever during the day.
Come watch
the fight
at nighttime. It's going to be an entertaining fight, too.
Give it up. That's awesome. I'm looking forward to seeing that.
Yeah, it's gonna be good. I can't wait to watch.
Yeah. What? How many rounds again?
6 rounds, 2 minute rounds, minute in between. Yeah. Hopefully he's ready.
Whew.
Sheesh.
Because I'm
exciting.
Ready.
All right. Well, let's get back to business.
Yep.
Because there's a lot of things going on in the business world, right? In the real estate world, and we very much look at our own specific neighborhoods, right? Yeah. On Tuesday, we open our minds up a bit of what's happening in LA County. We go to LA every Tuesday and just stay on top of our relationships out there. But for the most part, 80% of our focus is what's happening in Newport Beach, Costa Mesa, Corona del Mar, mm-hmm. Laguna Beach, North Tustin, Villa Park, you know, Orange, mm-hmm. Floral Park. We're very focused in this immediate of Coastal Orange County down to San Clemente, Dana Point.
Yep.
And from our experience, it is definitely a hot market the way we operate, meaning we are primarily listing agents. If you're a buyer's agent, I could see how it would be very difficult right now because there's not a lot of inventory. And if you find something and it's good, there's going to be seven or eight other offers. But I think for our world, for the most part, it feels pretty hot. Super active, mm-hmm. really busy. Mm-hmm. You know, I had the opportunity to be on Tom Ferry's podcast recently. I think it officially dropped last week.
Yeah.
And if you listen to Tom, one of the things that you'll hear in a lot of his communication is that it has been a slower year transaction-wise. It has been rough for a lot of agents. And so, and that's true. As we go back and look at the numbers, the amount of transactions, Costa, Newport, CDM, this year, you know, we're about to enter into October, quarter four, it's like 50% less transactions. Than 2021. And not 50% less agents, so a lot less meat on the bone. I just got the report of where we're at year to date for Team Stirdivant, where we're at as a brokerage. As a brokerage, we're definitely gonna surpass last year's numbers. As a team, we're gonna have to step it up because we had two quarters last year where we did over 90 million.
We had a big Q4 last year.
Big Q4 and a big Q2. Yeah. Both of those quarters we did over 90 million. And our best quarter this year has been like 70 million.
I think we have a track record of having big Q4s.
Yeah.
Like the last few years, at least since I've been with you, we always tend to have a few big deals pop off in December.
Yeah, man. Well, listen, if you have a big deal that would like to quote-unquote pop off, we're here for you. We're here to assist in the popping off of that transaction. And a smaller transaction.
Right. Anything.
Listen,
transaction.
If you have real estate goals anytime in the next decade, you should probably reach out to us and plan.
Yes.
That being said, we want to know what's going on in the mortgage world, ladies and gentlemen. Yes. So we're always looking to introduce you guys to absolute pros, absolute Jedis. So today we got a legend for you, legend in the game. Give it up, let's make some noise for my dude Mario. Bring him up. You sit there,
yeah.
Let's go, man.
Alrighty, gents. Thanks for having me.
Who are you? What are you all about? Thanks for being here.
Thanks for having me.
Yeah, thank you.
Appreciate it. Love the energy in here. It's a good time right here.
It's a great
synergy. Is
the most fun real estate podcast.
I can see it. No, I love it. Yeah, thanks for having me here, guys. Mario Montecinos, owner of Brokerage M&M Capital, specializing in a couple different things, but mostly niche lending, investment property financing, and niche individuals that need money outside of a bank.
What percentage of your business is investment property that you lend on?
Probably 80%.
80%
right now.
That's awesome, man. What's the average kind of investment property? Duplexes, triplexes, fourplexes, multiple units?
Yeah, it ranges from single family to multifamily.
Okay. Yeah,
I would say is, and then a little bit of smaller commercial buildings. Right now, I just did a transaction on a barbershop, and next door I had a couple little offices next to it. So smaller type stuff in LA.
How long have you been in the game?
19 years.
Wow.
Yeah.
That's awesome, man.
Yeah.
What's the biggest change you've seen? What was the best year you've ever seen as a mortgage Jedi in your 19 years?
Right. I would say this year's pace on that.
Yeah?
That's the best year.
Wow. Oh, wow.
That's good to hear.
I would say that it would not be what we'd hear from the majority of mortgage dudes.
Yeah.
Why would you say 2023 is your best year as a mortgage guy?
I think with mortgage or really anything service based, like if you go really really deep in niche, right?
Yeah.
What you're identifying and what you're providing and the value that you're adding, and you're organized with like maintaining a database and growing a database,
right?
And you're relationship oriented.
Yeah.
Like it's just a snowball effect for what I've seen.
So are more of your clientele investing in this market right now then? Is that why your business has right. you know, maintained while I would say a big majority of mortgage people, it's the opposite?
Right. What do you think? A lot of the investors right now, they're bold, right? They're buying something today, hopefully at the right discount, and they're anticipating that in the sometime immediate future, typically stuff is turning over within a year, maybe a year and a half, that there's going to be appreciation in the market, and they're gonna make a profit, right? And then also the investor that's investing today, do they believe in the cash flow is going to be different in a year and a half, 2 years when they're able to refinance and have a lower interest rate? Do they think that if rates come down, there's more demand that comes into the market, even more so, and then that's going to drive up prices as
right,
well,
right?
And make it a lot more challenging to you know, to secure the property when there's more competition. Yeah. Right. So, yeah, I mean, they're, you know, it's all those things that are playing into
it. Wow, man, that's awesome. Yeah. So, and I know you've invested yourself. I've experienced that.
Yep.
A few years back, I threw something out on the market, and there were multiple people, and you came in and you souped it up.
Yeah.
So, what have you learned? Like, what kind of advice would you have for an investor? Right. Like, if somebody, let me ask you this question.
Sure.
What if somebody doesn't want to buy their own? They're fine renting, or they're living at home, right? Mm-hmm. And they're like, I'm gonna go buy something for a couple million bucks. I'm good here. I'm able to have low rent, or I'm able to live with my family for free, whatever it is. What would be your number one recommended investment if you've got 800 to a million bucks and you don't want to buy your personal residence? Or would you say no matter what, go buy your personal residence even if you're living for free? What would be your advice?
Yeah, right off the bat, when I think of real estate, I think the power of real estate is your ability to leverage, right?
Okay.
Like, you know, your ability to put a small portion down to what the asset's worth, or to what that piece of real estate, $1 million piece of real estate, to secure that piece of real estate, you could potentially do that with like $50,000, right?
Right.
Or less.
Okay.
Right, in some circumstances. So when I think of, okay, that's great, an asset, a real estate, I think if you're buying your first one, I would hands down say, really, really considered a duplex.
Okay.
And a duplex with a decent lot.
Right.
Right. Because not only do you have, eventually, you know, you're going to have, you have two pieces of, two units in there that are going to give you rent, but potentially there's room for an ADU, right?
Now, so real quick, because you said something that I'm curious about, where you said, you know, you could secure something even with 50,000 bucks. So I know that's going to perk a lot of ears of the listeners. Like, what do you mean? What can I do with 50,000 bucks? Like, what's an example of something you could do with 50,000 bucks?
Right. I'll give you, and like when you talked about personally, what have you done? So I always give advice of things that I've personally experienced myself.
Right.
I've beta tested myself. I have a very tight knit of investors that continue to come back and I lend them money. And I see it happening. So there's a couple different things. When you're, you know, in a position to purchase a property and you want to put down a minimum down payment and make a sacrifice maybe for a short period of time,
right?
And that is your primary residence,
right?
Right. You can leverage into that, right? And then, you know, down the road, the story changes. You want to turn that into a rental property,
right?
You know, that's all doable.
Got
right?
it. So you're talking about like an FHA financing.
Correct.
Yeah. 3.5%. FHA is 3.5% down.
Correct.
Yeah. So if you buy something for, what does FHA go up to in Orange County? Do you know?
It depends on the different units, but you can go. I mean, a duplex, you're over $1 million for sure.
Wow. And so you can buy a duplex FHA financing. Now, when you buy it, do you have to buy it as your
primary? Yes,
okay.
I do. 100%.
But you can still buy an income property with FHA financing. So at $1 million property, you've got to come up with 30 G's.
Correct.
Yeah.
Yeah, 3.5% down would be the minimum down payment as a primary residence transaction. Then down the road, you know, it turns into an investment property, right? It's everything. I think there's always an element of a sacrifice in order to have any kind of growth, right?
Yeah.
You're not able to run 7 miles on day one, right?
Right.
You have to do some kind of sacrifice and anything to make anything kind of worthwhile. So,
you know, I love this conversation too, man, because I think when some people think about it, it seems so far.
Mm-hmm.
Like, you don't, you never purchased something before and you're like, what, can I buy a house? Like, that sounds insane. But when you really break it down to the fact that there are FHA loans and you can buy a duplex. So for example, if you find a duplex for $1 million, let's just say, right? What's the, at a FHA, what's the loan gonna be like on an FHA deal at $1 million?
I was just having a conversation last week with a client, and you know, they live at a very low rent.
Yeah.
So the leap is, and I understand it. And I mean, a lot of people are in this situation where they like where they live, right? They live in Newport Beach, they live in Balboa Island, they live in, you know, a cool area, Costa Mesa, or whatever the case is. Like,
well, I think that's the first thing, right? No matter what the hell you buy, it ain't gonna be as cool as your mom's house.
Right.
When you get to have dinner for free and it's free, and it's not going to be cool as the really cool apartment building you rent with the rooftop pool and the parties on the weekends, blah, blah, blah. It's not going to be that cool.
Yeah.
This is a legacy play.
Correct.
You know, this is a long-term play. So you got to get that out of your mind.
Right.
To the fact that it's not going to be as cool, but what is going to be cool is when you look at the equity that you're building up. Right. So, like, what kind of payment would FHA financing $1 million be?
So let's say just on average, let's say that payment was $7,500.
Okay.
Right. And then the other market rent for the other unit to rent out is $3,000.
Yeah.
Right. So now you're in it for, you know, $4,500.
Right.
Is basically the net that you got to pay in rent, which is not that far. Then it becomes the gap becomes a pretty close to what you're paying right now, or maybe that's even or a little less, or it's much more palatable at that point.
Right. Well, and you got to figure, here's what's really rad about that, right? It's like, so you put down your 3.5%, you know, your $35,000, whatever it is, $40,000.
Right.
What the other unit is paying after 1 year is what you paid to buy the place.
It's amazing.
Yeah. But I think it's just that mindset. What's the right. first step? What's the first step that a buyer should do if they're like, all right, damn it, I get it. I want to own something. I want to buy some units. What's the first thing they got
to
do?
I would say talk to your realtor or whoever, if you have a lender, that partner that you know with, talk to them and see what's real. Have a conversation with them to get pre-approved, so then you basically know what you're working with, right? Mm-hmm. And then then from there you can start guiding the conversation. What are your goals? And then what is reality,
right?
And put it together in the big picture, right? And you talked about the rent being there right after a year, but also to put, I mean, nothing is guaranteed, but the potential for appreciation. Let's just say 5%. 5% appreciation.
Bro.
So now you got 50 on $1 million asset. Now the asset's worth $1,050,000, and you only put $35,000 in. Like, that's pretty powerful. That's why the power of leverage in real estate is a super, super powerful
100%.
Thing, right?
Man, I bought a property on the whim once. I was out in Montana randomly in 2020. And I had just closed on a property December 15th in Big Bear, like our second or third Airbnb in Big Bear. And normally we go to Oahu in December, and this was 2020, so it was all weird, and we couldn't go to Hawaii. So some friends of ours, Ella and Vic, they're like, well, we bought a home in Bozeman. And we're like, where the hell is Bozeman? Like, in Montana. I'm like, that's cool. Like, you guys should really come. I'm like, we ain't going to Montana. We don't know what there is to do there. And then they start sending us photos of Big Sky and all this stuff. We're like, you know what? We love hanging out with Vic and Ella and their kids. And Marcy and Teppy. Worst case, we're just hanging out with them. Nothing to do in Montana. We land in Montana December 27th. Mm-hmm. I'm in escrow December 30th.
Oh.
3 days left.
3 days later.
Wow.
And I fell in love, man. We caught the bug. We caught the Montana bug really quick. Then we got pregnant. And then we realized that we're not going up there as much as we thought.
Mm-hmm.
I start to share it on Instagram and it goes off on my IG. And next thing you know, I sold it to this really nice mortgage dude from Newport Beach, made a killing. Let's go.
Let's do it. Yeah, we love it.
I still need to go. And it's in our contract. It was really difficult. Azella's still mad at me that we sold that place.
Okay.
It's in our contract that I get to go back for a week.
That's fine.
Hey, you still got plenty of credits. They have not
Thanks,
expired
bro.
Yet.
Thank you, man.
We're ready.
But honestly, like, now here's the deal. When you sell an investment property to you have to, if you don't want to get heavily taxed, you got to do what's called a 1031 exchange.
Mm-hmm.
So you have to take the money that you earned, which we earned a good amount of money, and put all of that into another rental property.
Mm-hmm.
Because of that, we were able to purchase two insane properties that we wouldn't have been able to purchase otherwise.
That's awesome.
Because we made this investment. Now, mind you, we also went up to Montana, enjoyed the house, loved the house. And appreciation, we sell it, we buy 8 acres out in Yucaipa, and then we bought one of my favorite Airbnbs ever that we've ever had. Like one of the only really architectural homes that you can see in Big Bear.
Nice.
We found it, wrote a dude a letter. None of that would have been possible if we didn't take the leap of faith.
Mm-hmm.
We did not have the money that we needed to buy that house in Montana when we wrote the offer.
Mm.
We just closed on a home 15 days before we wrote the offer on that one, but we asked for a 60-day escrow.
Wow.
Actually, we asked for a 90-day escrow. They countered back at 60, and I'm like, F it. Let's figure it out, because this thing's one of a kind. Mm-hmm. And worst case, we're not ready at the 20-day mark, and we'll just have to back out, but let's go for it.
Right.
And so that's the thing about real estate, is you have to be willing to take risks mm-hmm. and go for it and hustle. Right. You know what I mean?
Absolutely.
What advice would you have for investors or anybody looking to buy a home in this crazy 2023?
Sure. I mean, from everything I'm seeing on the supply side, and also with a lot of the private money lending that I do, and I'm seeing how they have become more aggressive because they have confidence in the market as far as like appreciation. Mm. When you talk about private money for individuals in particular, right, they're making loans that are basically on the collateral and the value add of the property, right? So they're heavily invested with their risk in it,
right.
And I see them as of last, I would say 60 days or so, they've actually increased leverage what they will allow, right? So, you know, you have to understand what you're getting into. You're not doing this stuff blind. You're going to talk to your advisors and listen to them and understand them. But at some point, you will need to take the leap.
Right.
But it just starts with a step, right?
Yeah.
Step one: talk to your guy or girl to see if what is really possible,
right?
And then from there, you know, you're gonna find a property that it's gonna work. It's not gonna be your dream home,
right? Yeah.
But there's a way to do it, and you just you go from there. And I love the real estate story because I bought real estate in 2005, arguably the worst time ever to buy real estate, right?
Right.
And just the climate, the lending climate that was happening at that point in time, and to be able to buy in that time, and then that property was successful. As a rental that turned into a rental and had appreciation that allowed me to buy another property, similar story that you're doing.
Well, and that's
so it's
the
like
thing.
If you can go and like.
You gotta find the deal.
Right.
Right? There's people who made incredible buys, and mm-hmm. then I've got friends who made buys, and it was a big L.
Mm-hmm.
Like, you have to buy the right property.
Yep.
I know from experience working with you, not only now on the loan side, you did the loan for us on an investment property. We had never done. A loan where you also finance the construction. What's that loan called?
Fix and flip.
Right?
Yep.
So we found a property off market worth $2 million. We got the opportunity to buy it for a mil. It needs $250,000. Mm-hmm. So not only did you get us the loan to buy the property, mm-hmm. you got us this loan where inside of the loan there's a certain amount. How much was that certain amount? Is that like another $250,000 or something?
Yeah, say $200,000.
And then we basically use that money as we go.
Correct.
Right? And so as a personal client of Mario's, highly recommend you get in touch with this dude. He knows his stuff. How do people get a hold of you?
You can cell phones 562-787-8902 and then easily email me mario@marioloans.com.
Look, awesome. We only bring people up in here who really know their stuff. We've been getting blown up by lenders left and right. Hey, can I come on?
Yeah.
Like, look, if we don't know you personally and know your track record, it's too risky to share with our circle of people who we care about, mm-hmm. Individuals that we don't know if they really know their stuff.
Mm-hmm.
And you're definitely somebody that knows his stuff. You live it. I've gone through it myself. Working with you on our North Tustin deal, and you killed it for us. So, thank you, man. Anything else you want to tell the people?
No, I just it's a pleasure to be on here. Feel free to reach out to me, and it's definitely an honor. But definitely, it's a leap of faith.
Yes,
and you have to be bold, right?
Well, and start. Like,
start.
Take a meeting. Hit Mario up. If you're not around here, you can still hit him up for a phone call and schedule time to begin taking that step. I've had buyers that I was talking to for 3 years mm-hmm. before they bought something, but they still started.
Mm-hmm. Sure.
They still started. So take the first step. I always tell buyers, have you talked to a lender yet? If they say no, I say, here's a couple people.
Yeah.
Call me back when you do. And sometimes it takes people a long time just to take that first step.
Sure.
So take that first step, and before you talk to a real estate person, in my opinion, you have to talk to a lender.
For sure.
You have to talk to a lender. That's the first thing. So.
Nice.
Yeah, Kyle's going to hit you up later today because from the money he's going to win from the fight, he's going to buy new credit.
Roll that into it.
Woo!
Yeah.
There you go.
Fire, man.
That's a good plan.
Yeah. Give it up for my dude Mario Montecinos. Let's go.
Let's go.
Thank you, brother.
Thank you, man.
Appreciate it, man.
It's awesome.
Yeah, thanks so much.
Well, thanks, bro. Appreciate it. Thank you, man.
Thank you, thank you.
All right, so last but not least, let's talk about some hacks. Let's talk about some
life hacks.
Life hacks. We always like to bring in that sponsored by Project Mindset part of the podcast. This is the part that's, you know, about helping people stay focused, stay inspired, growth. Mm-hmm. Because, you know, like I said, KASE is a real estate and personal development company. We like to work with people on their big dream, their big vision in life. And if a big dream home is a part of that, great. But for a lot of people, it's just sharing this piece.
Mm-hmm.
The part that I want to share is about perspective.
Ooh.
Perspective, right? As the saying goes, when you change the way you look at things, the things you look at change. I believe that's the legendary Wayne Dyer. I was watching you know my dude Wayne, man, rest
good
in peace
Wayne.
To the GOAT. And I was watching this video that is so powerful. It's by Jocko. If you don't know who Jocko is, this guy is like, he's who you want. Jocko's
yeah.
Jocko Willink is who you want
to
be.
After you
and just look up Jocko, J-O-C-K-O.
I have a visual image of what Jocko looks like. Let's see.
And then look up Good. Look up his video on Good. If you're ever feeling lazy, if you're ever feeling sorry for yourself, if you're ever feeling like poor me.
Oh, this military guy?
Look up Jocko Willink's video on Good. And what he talks about is that really the mindset that you have to have when adversity arises, you have to have the ability to say, good. You didn't get the job? Good. Right?
That's him.
Somebody backstabbed you, you have to enter this lawsuit. You know, you didn't get paid on a deal. Like Steven and I are about to go into arbitration. Good. I've never experienced arbitration before. I get to see what this experience is like. And share that with the world.
Yeah.
Good. And it was just about perspective and how not to get frustrated, how to really just see everything that comes your way as an opportunity to learn and improve.
Yeah, it's good.
So that's my message for this week is about perspective. Shout out to Wayne Dyer. When you change the way you look at things, the things you look at change. And just go watch my dude Jocko's video.
That's good. I know who he is. I've seen him now looking at his picture.
Yeah, powerful.
Yeah, he's good. I like him.
Yeah. What do you guys got for this?
I have a joke. I'll wait for the joke at the end.
Okay.
I have a good joke.
That's your tip?
I've been waiting.
That's fine, man. That's cool.
So now I got a platform.
That's cool, man. You really.
This joke better be good.
This better be
a good
one.
It's a good joke.
All right.
That's funny. All right. Well, I'm just thinking back about like, a lot of my self-development and like a lot of the things I've learned about mindset and growing as a human being occurred actually shortly before I started here at KASE.
Yeah.
Was when I kind of got introduced to you know, the things that you can do and the things that you can focus on to just excel in every area of life.
Yeah.
And one thing that you hear this a lot from like different self-help books and from like different podcasts and you know, all sorts of things,
is
that who you surround yourself with plays a really big role 100%. in who you become, and I think in the direction that you can go. And I look back at my own experiences, and I look back at, you know, when I started this job and the people that I was blessed to be surrounded by, you know, with the team here and just with the clients that we've met and the things that I chose to start listening to. I made a really big difference in the way that I saw life. Again, perspective,
right?
It's like they talk about that bowl of fruit. And if there's one bowl in there there's one fruit in there that's rotting and it's touching all the other fresh fruit, that just starts to like spread.
Yeah.
And I think it's really easy sometimes, like if you're someone who is just trying to figure out like what it is that you'd like to do, and maybe you know for yourself that you kind of want to get out of your current situation and do something better for yourself.
Yeah.
Sometimes the easiest way is to change the people that you surround yourself with. And two, nowadays with like the vast ability for you to like just listen to different podcasts and stuff online, you can really change the way that you think and the way that things I think occur for you by just hanging around the right people, hanging around people who are positive,
it's crucial,
hanging around people who are open-minded, hanging around people who strive to look for new perspectives in life, people who are honest, people who are kind, people who are loving. Makes a really big difference, and it's made a really big difference in the way that I've grown. I've seen a lot of my friends start to put themselves in the right positions and have grown tremendously. So
that's crucial, man.
It is crucial. I remember there's a video that Jesse Itzler, huge entrepreneur and extremely successful dude, when he was just starting in his career, he wanted to, you know, position himself in like the right places.
Right.
And he would go to the Beverly Hills Hotel. He found a hack that if you order a salad, you can sit there all day. And it's the same thing, like putting yourself around people who, you know, are in maybe situations that you want to get to, or they're in, they're at a part in their life where you want to get to. So surround yourself around with the right people, and it makes a huge difference in life.
Yeah, I read this quote from this guy, Zach Bia, who's in LA, knows a lot of the right people, right? Hangs out with Drake, all these guys.
I remember mysterious
on
dude.
But on his Forbes interview, he said, meeting the right people is a skill set, and positioning yourself within the right people is a skill set.
Right, right.
So that was his thing. His goal was, okay, let me position myself in the places I want to be to get to where I want to be. Like, he wasn't just going to magically meet the right people. He had to be in that space and put himself in that space to meet those people.
Yeah, that's big. That's big.
Yeah.
Yeah, I saw something the other day, and I don't know how they come up with these stats, but they said if you hang out with somebody that is like a lot more productive than you and effective than you, then your production, just being next to them, is going to increase by 15%.
Yeah.
But if you hang out with somebody who's doing less than you and less effective than you, then your production will decrease by 30%.
Oh, wow.
Right, so
it's pretty crazy.
How you know, you are who you spend your time with.
Yeah,
and
yeah.
That's why for us, and even with our team, and even with our company, we're very particular with bringing the right kind of individual in here. Like, I think it's a lot less even about the volume that they do, and more about the energy that they bring.
Yeah, for sure.
Yeah. No, listen, man. We are really proud of the growth that you've had on your journey for this fight. I feel like we've watched you become a man through this journey. You know, the arms went from like very like wet spaghetti arms to, you know, some
bigger arms.
Just some bigger arms.
Yeah.
Your inability to run half a block just 3 years ago, you know. We have other incidents that I can mention that I'll take with me to the grave until I need to on those running
days. Well, I think, so like, actually, like, you speaking about this. About. Yeah, I know exactly what you're talking about.
Change the subject real quick.
So, like, I think.
He's like, hold up.
I think it's also just finding what makes you, finding joy in your day-to-day life, right? Like, that kind of lifts you up quite a bit. And, like, I'm a very competitive person. I love sports. But I've been so disconnected from that. And I think finding this thing again, that competitive nature, gives me that lift of like,
100%.
Gives you that extra boost to want to be better, you know?
How you are in one area is how you are everywhere, right? So we're constantly looking, why we do this podcast? Are we gonna sell some homes of this from this podcast? I don't know. It'd be great if we did, right?
Yeah.
But that's not our core purpose. Our core purpose is because we enjoy being people who uplift, who inspire, who share and give information. And so if we can create a structure where, and we enjoy doing this, right? This isn't difficult to get on the mic and just like talk about what we have going on. And so from a podcast to the motivational stuff that KP and I do and Project Mindset to this fight, to the run club, we definitely want to encourage people to implement things within your work life.
Yeah.
That actually give you joy, where you don't necessarily need to produce something or like, I don't need to close a deal from this podcast in order to keep this podcast going forever.
Yeah.
You don't need to sell a house from the run club in order to do the run club forever. You don't need to have somebody who is like watching the fight. Oh, Kyle, man, the way you hit him with that uppercut, I just really think you're going to barely get me top dollar from the house. You know what I mean? It's about like, what can you add to, you never know.
You never know.
What can you add to your work dynamic right. that's going to give you life,
yeah.
bring you joy,
I think it's
and impact
creating,
the rest.
It's creating a really compelling future for yourself.
Yeah.
Because I think if you're not living with a vision that is compelling enough to you, you're most likely going to be living in your past.
Ooh, that's
and it's usually not a healthy place to live.
Look at you. Hey, guys, this is episode 9. In case you missed it, shout out to everybody that's been listening.
Yes.
Hit us with ideas, ways that we can make this better for
yeah,
you.
Yeah,
we
yeah.
want to continue this going. And keep us in mind, too, by the way, for any of your real estate goals. If
yeah,
you, if
absolutely.
You, if
We'd
you can't,
love to help.
You know, find Mario's number. Shoot us a DM. We'll make sure to get it to you.
Mm-hmm.
But this is our passion. Personal development and real estate. We love seeing people grow and improve, and we love seeing people grow and improve their real estate portfolio.
Yeah.
So any real estate goals you have, from the desert to the sea to the mountains to the city, we're here for you. Stay focused, stay inspired. We'll see you next week.
Let's go.
Yeah.